Not everyone can afford to buy food or even a meal this Christmas Eve, and that's where a little generosity makes a big difference. Some elves who rival Santa's have been hard at work to make sure no one goes without on Christmas in Spartanburg County. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local from our Spartanburg newsroom. This is an annual gift, isn't it, Mike?
It is, Gabrielle, and it happens at the Spartanburg Soup Kitchen, proof that hunger never takes a holiday.
This is an annual tradition for Ollie Smith.
This is very important to me.
Cherries, pineapples.
Not just the cooking, but the gift it provides.
That's the enjoyment of it. When they come through those doors there, come to that window, oh boy, they'll say, Miss Ollie, what you got today?
At the Spartanburg Soup Kitchen, the Christmas lunch they'll serve Saturday isn't only about the food, it's about the family.
Just a wonderful meal for those who might not be able to go home to mom, I might not even have a home to go to.
In 2008, they fed some 600 people, and every year the number's gone up.
We've seen a great increase with our children population, especially the Latino community.
Donations make it all possible.
It's all fully cooked, all you got it sliced and everything.
Yeah, it's all great.
From the ham one man dropped off to the pans of food given by an area restaurant, you see generosity in action here, and not just on Christmas.
This week we've given out 850 blankets. We've given out toiletries to over 600 people.
A record number of people are expected here on Saturday, and after they eat, they'll leave with a bag of food.
You can sling them.
Getting ready to play Santa for yet another year.
I got one motto to say, that if I can only help somebody as I travel this way, then I know my living won't be in vain.
And Christmas lunch there at the Spartanburg Soup Kitchen will be served at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. And the one thing they really need right now is gloves to get those they help through this winter. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg Newsroom.